Hey guys, today I have a tutorial for you, something that's very tricky. Very often when people throw a kick, they drop, and then they throw their follow-up techniques, but we're gonna be working on kick to punch, and I've utilized this technique before, except I went knee to punch. But this is a very advanced technique that is super effective if you know how to utilize it correctly. After the intro, I'm gonna throw up some clips of other fighters utilizing this technique so well. So today, guys, we're working on a rapid fire kick to punch combo. All right, guys, the reason I'm so excited about this tutorial is this is a technique you see very rarely. You can watch a whole fight card, a whole UFC, a whole Bellator, a whole ONE FC event, and you will probably see nobody throw it. And generally that means that the technique is not worth it, but this technique is definitely worthwhile learning and is very effective. So let's just recap very quickly what often happens. You're in your fighting stance, somebody throws the kick, they come back down, and then they punch. And while that's a very effective technique, it lacks speed. So if somebody's throwing a kick towards you, they go one, they drop down, and then they come two. You're gonna have time to block, reset your hands, and then block the cross in whatever way you want. But if the guy goes kick to punch, and somebody is doing their cross block, that block in their round kick, with their hands a little bit low, if they keep their hands right up really high, this won't work well. But if somebody comes right to here and their hands a little bit low, you can find that opening over top. Now this technique requires a few very key things. The first is a lack of hip rotation. And you will hear me teach all the time, when I throw a round kick, you have to turn those hips, turn that chest over. Everything twists. But if you do that on this technique, when you twist and now you come to punch, you have nothing left through your upper body because you already put in the whole rotation. So what you really want to do on this one is when I round kick, look at my shoulders. They would normally come to here, but now they're going to come just to here. Now when I drop, I can rotate through my body to get that snap. Being very mindful of the hip is very important, and you can play around with your punch angle. It could either be one to two, or I prefer personally coming one and then across. And you will note my standing leg, if it started right here on the kick, it steps out and it takes an angle. So I cut that 45 degree angle, which makes the punch easier to land. Now, this is a technique you have not seen me throw in my fights. I utilize it all the time in sparring, but it has not come out in competition yet. But I wanna throw up a clip right now of one of my favorite fighters, Artur Kashenko, landing it. The only difference you'll see right now is he is landing this shot from a jab. I don't utilize this technique in this way. I prefer going off the back leg, but if you get your skip off, and you remember about the shoulder rotation, the lack of shoulder rotation, then you can certainly land the shot like he did. The timing is the big key on this. If a normal technique, let's say our normal beat is like that, we're going one, two, three, four, five. On this one, we need to make sure that it's a little tap, tap, pop, pop. Before your opponent has time to adjust and you've changed levels on them so dramatically, you've not only changed heights, but you've also changed the angle at which you're attacking. The round kick comes here, and the punch is coming more down the center. Makes it very difficult to go from one to two. You have to be very on point, very precise. I'm gonna give you guys a couple demos here of a nice full speed example of this technique being executed. So again, big key is the speed. I wanna come up. I'm not trying to put too much power into this kick. It's just to get the guy's hands off that center line so I can land that shot. So instead of crashing my kick in really hard, I'm just tapping. And then from there I can follow up with my cross. So my hands are up and I just go tap. And one more time with a little bit more power. For me, working off the lead arm, the lead leg with the skip, it doesn't feel as powerful, but I'll give it a shot here. I come with my skip, one, two. I mean, I can still knock Bob over one more time. One, two. These type of techniques, like when I fought Kevin Ross, when I got control of an arm in the head and I went one and came down with the hook very quickly, you don't see these techniques very often, and they throw people off because the timing is a surprise. Would I say it's a priority to work these techniques? No, the basics are more important, but once you can start getting the basics down super easy, they're just natural to you, muscle memory is kicked in every time, then you can move on to these techniques. You just need to make sure you go through all the little details that I mentioned. Not turning your hips over, using the kick is a simple setup instead of a follow through power technique. And one other really important point is, what does my arm do as I kick? A lot of times when people kick, they swing. I do that very often too, but if I do that right now, then I have to bring my hand back up and throw the punch. So instead of swinging like I would on a full power kick, I just keep my hand there so that it's ready to fire out. But you don't have to swing your arm every single time you kick. There is the option of just keeping it there, especially if you have somebody who's trying to land big punches. Sometimes you're better off just keeping your hands up tight to the head until you get a feel for their distance, their power, their ability to counter you. So guys, I hope this was an exciting tutorial for you. Maybe something new you'd never seen before. Something for you to try in the gym or at home. If you want to try this and you don't have a bag or anything, it doesn't matter. You can still utilize it. It's just one, two. Come up, one, two. One, two. Shoulders very square. Snap the kick and then rotate the shoulders on the drop. It's almost kind of like a Superman where you launch your leg out, but I'm just throwing the kick beforehand and I'm not extending my leg, but the idea is somewhat similar. If you guys enjoyed the video, give it a like. If you haven't already, get subscribed. Train hard, guys, and I'll see you back here soon for another video.